This terrain used to be a cattle ranch, used only for livestock. There were no trees, just the occasional one in each paddock. What's funny is that I came here to get away from miners because they had overtaken my farm in Caucasia, the Mandiga farm, and so I came running. But as I was building a pool for the farm, someone decided to wash off some of the material being dug out and found gold. So for gold, I've been invaded again. In other words, miners have been here at the farm for the past 25 years. Rio Rayo used to look like this here, only grass, pure livestock. There were around 1,500 heads of cattle. But the major issue for the lower Cauca is mining, informal mining, irrational mining, any mining you can think of. It's also a generational problem. Everything you see there is the hill left over from the old reforestation, everything that continues over there. That used to be like this. You had to bulldoze the terrain to even it out. In the beginning, everyone was a traditional miner. Whole families that used to come and wash sand with their wooden plates, but then it got complicated in the sense that they started buying machines with their motors to wash, and so the damage to the earth started to worsen as time went by. What we have over there is a paddock called Las Brechas. When we first arrived here, this had been mined by the Spanish when they colonized. They entered here through caseras. So just imagine, it was mined, used for livestock for several years, and then mined again. And after a third time, trees were planted. Here we have a chance to see just how much damage these machines make, since, as you've seen, the earth is being drilled by several meters below the surface. We've been worried about the damage caused for the last 18 years or so. And so we have started to think about how we can recover this land, an area that keeps growing. What did we do? We wanted to maintain possession of the earth to keep the farm, and it hurt to see the damage that mining was doing. Mining is, especially this flood of it, not underground but exposed like this in the open. The damage is very obvious. And so you see how 4 hectares have been completely destroyed, how there are holes that are 40 meters deep, very big holes, and you think that that is just not reversible. In view that the damage is so visible, so enormous, and in view that I'm concerned about the damage and worried about how to recover that ground, I spoke to a few able organizations in order to gather some information, and they helped me find out about the variety needed to replant, a type that could accommodate to an acidic ground with a pH of around 3.5 or 4, very acid. That organization was able to find the right type called Acacia mangium from Asia. We got the seed and we formed an association, that organization and myself, or the farm, to plant that variety that we are now experiencing here, which has adjusted very well. This, imagine that this was only planted 3 months ago, and look at how it's going. You can see that we are planting as soon as the miner starts moving away from the farm. Living through the whole issue, first experiencing it in Caucasia, in the farm called Mandinga, where the gold kicked us out and so we came here, only for it to be found here as well, where it was worse or the same. We decided to see how we could recover the farm, first so that it can retain some value, and second, to see how we can add to that destruction a form of construction or reconstruction, one that could be sustainable in the long run. And now the story continues. There is a company now here that has planted 80 hectares of wood, and we discovered that the Acacia mangium grows anywhere, even on a rock. But then we saw that properly planted wood, properly sustained and maintained, could come to be an important business. That's how, for around the past 7 years, we started to think about the sawmill we have here at the house and in the majority of the farms. The historical landscape of these mining zones where we worked has gone from being a paddock where there has been a high volume of livestock to a mining zone. And so let's say that the landscape changes from pastures to very rocky terrain. Then it goes from that rocky terrain caused by mining to a reforestation process. Antioquia is more about mining than about livestock. This area has been 100% a traditional mining area from grandparents, ancestors, and one which values the gold underneath my feet more than the cow that's on it. And so we either join forces with a person or company, like in this case, one that meets all the requirements, even for informal mining, since the license is there, but meeting the requirements for responsible mining, or else everyone will come. What happens with the kind of mining we're doing here? It's responsible mining that not only recovers the environment, it also gives jobs. Fair jobs, let's call it that, since it meets government standards, like it or not, and say you're earning more or less, but it's fair for us, since there is parafiscal contribution, industrial security, everything, in order to consider the miner as not being exploited, but as a being, a person that is within the Colombian legislation and is okay. Therefore, we have made this enterprise into a family business, where my brother Ivan and Juan Humberto, everyone, have tried to stay in line with the environment, as well as being responsible with the social side. We find that, starting with the miner, that miner that came and gave it blood and sweat, as with everything, not bad and not good, just a miner that was raised with force, and, how should I say it, and maybe we don't like it, but who never had the presence of the state in his education, where the miner also didn't have social security, so he forces himself in. And if the money is down there, he will take it out. So what we're trying to do is, okay, we're going to do terrible damage, but with a responsible person that will allow for there to be a recovery right after the damage. As for the social part, the most important, there has to be a social component so that everyone around can make money from that gold, not just one person. It's a process that demonstrates what we call an early victory, where, from mining, you can work sustainably, thinking of a future after extracting gold. If you leave the gold in the ground, that gold, like it or not, is going to become a problem either today or tomorrow, because illegal mining is permeating this region and all areas, generating great contamination, great and unhealthy social and environmental impact, bringing forth several negative things. What we're trying to do is, okay, there's going to be mining, today or tomorrow. How can we extract that mineral in a responsible way, thinking of the future? So the mining we're doing today is in such a way that gives us the capacity to generate new roads, generate new forestry processes, generate new jobs, generate a stable economy for the region, and so the local communities can be benefited by the project. Here, we place a bit of technology into the plant nurseries. In other words, mycorrhizae are given to the certified seed, to the seedbed, so that the mycorrhizae can embed themselves in the roots and retain the nitrogen. We give some polymers that absorb water and that have a memory to water the plant some 50 times, and so in times of drought, plants die less often. In other words, the plant is helped and not just abandoned. We plant in all the cultural forms, and we have found that the acacia not only sticks, not only has honey, because it produces honey, is that it returns a lot of forage to the ground. Now we can find a forest within the forest, a secondary forest, let's say, not sure what it's called, where we see natural and local plants, trees, and some with useful wood that start growing in the forest, which means that acacia serves as a nurse for ground that has been completely degraded. We found that land degraded by mining has become a challenge for us as to how we can recover them, for livestock if you wish, but we found that we prefer planting, cutting and planting, cutting and planting, because wood and honey are more profitable for us. Because the objective was not just to make a profit from good wood, the objective was to recover the land. But as time has gone by, and with the assistance that we've had, a good technical assistance, we have been improving our cultivation systems. And, well, we have already planted 500 hectares here, and we keep planting, which means that we have polished off wood production. As for wood processing, as you've had the chance to see, we have put together a sawmill in order to process the wood. The sawmill is producing wood in different forms and is dedicating itself to the construction of beehives specially, because we are encouraging beekeeping in this entire region of the lower Cauca due to the interest that we have for everyone to produce honey, which is a healthy food, a very good antibiotic, as well as a profitable business. Therefore, we've created a beekeeping foundation as we encourage and teach many on the proper handling of beehives, and the production in the region is increasing. We haven't been selfish in the sense of being the only beekeepers here. Instead, we've created a beekeeping foundation, a beekeeper society. And to many, if not the majority, we have invited to come here to learn, because every farmer should have bees. Here we're looking at, checking on a hive. Let me help you with the smoke or the handle, Pedro. It's an adult hive that is made up by a floor that isn't normal like those traditionally used in normal type hives such as Langstroth types. It's a floor with a net on the bottom in order to contribute with the health of the hive so that it remains clean. Because it produces honey, which is a healthy food, a good antibiotic. And if you have a good number of hives, you can sell honey at a low cost, because a bee doesn't charge you for work. It's cheap labor. You don't have to feed it. Here in Colombia, the flowering is such that you don't have to feed them like in other countries. Good net production. So we're encouraging each farmer to have their own bees and here we're helping out with teaching. The characteristic of these bees, their genetics, is that it's a more organized bee. In terms of the percentage of production, it's much higher than that of African bees, and it's a bee that swarms less. The average for each frame is, for each side with honey, is 2.25 kilograms each one. As I was saying, what was before grassland is today a forest. It's not just that we recovered the land, we improved it. That is to say, the damage done, we did not equal how it was before. Instead, it improved it, because the production of oxygen by some blades of grass is quite different to that of a tree's. A tree is an oxygen factory. And so what we're doing is not just recovering, but improving and optimizing the ground's productivity.
El chingale que de por sí es derechito, y aquí en estas plantaciones se pone más derecho todavía.
When the growth of a tree has a process, it, let's say, sheds its leaves naturally, and those leaves fall to the floor on this ground that we're recovering.
En el sotobosque, en este suelo que se empieza a generar. Inicialmente, cuando uno arranca el proyecto de restauración de suelos mineros,
initially, when starting the ground restoration from mining projects, the project starts off with rocky ground. And once we have the first crop of trees, 10 to 15 years later, and then plant again, the ground already has topsoil containing nutrients for the ground. Allowing for the tree to develop for a forestry plantation. Once you see it as a plantation and not just planting trees for its own sake, but having a mind for business where, because of this, you can generate more than 30 to 40 jobs in the region. We still don't produce a high volume, but we're taking all the steps in order to get quality registers, qualifying us as organic, thinking of exporting, and having pure, single-flower honey. In other words, from one flower, which makes it of a better category from the other thousands of ordinary and common ones. So we're thinking of the official certification allowing us to export, on the certification of organic quality, and for that, we're putting together more and more hives. Right now, we have around 400, but we're thinking about having several thousand here, and for our neighbors to do the same. In one way or another, we're helping people who would otherwise not have a job, and so that's part of the job. What we most want is to give back to people work and training, since you have to teach people. Better than giving a fish is to teach how to fish, like they say. That is the idea. The benefit for the community is global, because that leads to a few things, like having a school. And if you have a school, that leads to having running water for one of the neighborhoods here called Puerto Antioquia. You have to do it, and it's done here in the farm, and the whole thing leads to there being development. Because if this were a cattle ranch, and this is 1,000 hectares big, if this were a cattle ranch, there would be 5, 6, 8 people working. And right now, there are more than 100 people working. That is the money that is circulating here with direct employment. It stays here in the community, because the one who's replanting is the one who's damaging the terrain. But we are advancing with the paddocks and changing them for trees. And so there are moments when we hire several hundred people, where before there were only 5 working livestock. We're not saying that we're going to change the natural disaster cost at the time. But we can say that we're going to do our part in developing the territory.